Hello everybody and welcome to this video in which I want to recall the definition of a manifold and I will introduce vector bundles. What is a manifold? Let me give you the general definition. In fact, one can proceed in several steps and let's begin with a topological manifold. A topological manifold of dimension n Well, first of all, it is a Hausdorff topological space. Thus, it is a topological space with a Hausdorff property, and we denote this topological space here by curly M usually. Moreover, we assume that this topological space is sigma compact. What does this mean? So it simply means that M can be written as an at most countable union of compact sets. Okay, so far it's a topological space which has nice properties, Hausdorff and sigma compact. But now the point is that the manifold is locally homeomorphic to Rn, to the Euclidean Rn. So let me explain what this means. So the condition is that every point of M has an open neighborhood. Let's write it like this. So for every point x in M, there exists a set in our topology with x in U, and moreover there should be a mapping phi from U to Rn with the properties that first of all the image of phi of U is open in Rn. So it's an open subset. And if you consider phi as a mapping from U to its image, to phi of U, that this is a homeomorphism. What does it mean, homeomorphism? So this means, first of all, that this mapping is bijective and that both phi and its inverse are continuous. Okay, so this is already what a topological manifold is. And this pair phi comma u is called a chart. And typically there are many charts because, well, for every point there is an open neighborhood and so on. So there are many such charts. And then one selects certain charts and forms what one calls an atlas, the collection of all charts. Of all charts defines an atlas, which we usually denote by script A. Okay, let me illustrate this by drawing a figure. Suppose this is now the topological space curly M, and then this condition is that for every point x, there is an open neighborhood u and a mapping phi, which now maps to Rn, and in fact to an open subset of Rn. Well, in this mapping phi is invertible. Maybe I should, yeah, phi to the minus 1 is of course a mapping from phi of u to u, and all these mappings should be continuous. Okay, so this is a topological manifold. Typically one wants to have more structures, or one needs more structures, namely one wants to talk of smooth function, one wants differentiable functions, smooth functions. And likewise, there's the notion of a differentiable manifold, and this is what I want to explain next. Now, what is a differentiable manifold? And in order to define this, we need to consider several charts, or two charts, and then state kind of compatibility conditions for these charts. Let me explain how this works. So this is again here our manifold. And now suppose we have like two charts, namely phi u and say phi prime u prime. So these should be two charts. So here I have u, here's u prime, well, and then I have the mapping phi, which maps here to an open subset of Rn, and likewise phi prime maps to an open subset of, well, phi prime of u prime is then again an open subset of Rn. Okay, suppose we consider two such charts, and let's also assume that the domain of these charts intersect. So this means we now consider here the intersection u intersected with u prime. This is again an open set, and on this set both charts are defined, and they again map these subsets homeomorphically to open subsets of Rn. Well, maybe I should have made this set here red, and then the image, whatever, gives me here a set like this and gives me here a set like this. Good, let me write this down in detail. So what are these restrictions? So if I restrict phi to u intersected u prime, then this is a mapping from u cap u prime to phi of u cap u prime, which is from the above, by the above definitions. So this means since phi is a homeomorphism onto an open subset, also phi of any open set is again an open set of Rn, so therefore this here is open. Well, and similarly, phi prime restricted to u and cap u prime is a mapping, of course, then to phi prime of u cap u prime. And again, this is an open subset of Rn. And these two mappings are, again, homeomorphisms. Homeomorphisms, what are the German versions? Homeomorphism, and the same here. Good. And now we do the following. So we consider the mapping, which we first take the phi inverse, and then we compose it with phi prime. This is the so-called transition map. So this is phi u cap u prime, phi prime restricted to u cap u prime composed with phi restricted to u cap u prime minus 1. So therefore this is a mapping of phi of u cap u prime to phi prime of u cap u prime. And this is again a homeomorphism. So this is already known, and this follows from the above definition. Okay, so this is a homeomorphism. But now the point is that this is a mapping from an open subset of Rn to another open subset of Rn. And since we are in Rn, we have additional structures. Now we can talk about differentiability, about smoothness, and all of this. And therefore, we can define a differentiable manifold. So this M is differentiable. Maybe I should better write it like this. Of course, somehow the atlas is part of the structure. So we have the topological space together with the atlas of charts is a differentiable manifold. If all the transition maps are diffeomorphisms. If all transition maps, so this means not only homeomorphism, but it should also be differentiable, the inverse is also differentiable. So if all transition maps are differentiable, or diffeomorphisms, let's better write it like this, are diffeomorphisms. Okay, and likewise, it's a smooth manifold. If all the transition maps are smooth. Maybe let's write for clarity, and their inverses. Of course, the inverse of a transition map is again a transition map, and somehow this is not needed, but I think it may serve just for clarity, and their inverses. Are smooth. Okay, so this means we take the differentiable smooth structure of Rn in order to define a corresponding structure of the manifold. Well, and since the M is only topological space, it doesn't have a differentiable structure a priori. So what we do is that we take all the transition maps to define a differentiable structure of the manifold. Okay, of course, there would be much more to say, but I mean, I want to here in the introductory videos, I want to really restrict to the basics, and therefore, let me now move on to bundles, to vector bundles. Now, what is a vector bundle? And well, again, there are different levels of generality here. And I thought that it's best to start really with a topological vector bundle. And then I will explain what does it mean. So it doesn't even need to be a manifold. So first of all, a topological vector bundle, just a topological spaces with some additional properties. And then I will also explain usually a vector bundle is a manifold or a smooth manifold. I will explain this afterwards. Okay, so the definition of a topological vector bundle. How does this work? I should say that there are various definitions in the literature. I chose the one which I find easiest, but of course it's a matter of taste. But in the end, if you understood one, you also understand the others. So what Scooby-Doo. So we take now two topological spaces. Let B for bundle and M be topological spaces. M is the base space, B is the bundle, and we consider and assume that there is a mapping, this so-called projection mapping from B to M, and this should be continuous and surjective. Okay, so this is the topological input. Next, we'll talk about vector bundles. We need a vector space, and this vector space is denoted by Y, capital Y. Let Y be a real or complex, doesn't really matter. Usually we consider complex vector spaces. Complex vector space. And moreover, we need a group, the so-called structure group. That's denoted by G for group. This is a subset of the general linear group acting on Y. So this is a group acting on Y. I mean, as a typical example, you can take all the invertible linear mappings from Y to Y. I mean, this is what this general linear group here is, but it could also be a subgroup, for example, the unitary mapping. Suppose, I mean, suppose typically once the vector space has additional structures, for example, a scalar product or an indefinite inner product, then the structure group will also be a proper subgroup of the general linear group, for example, the unitary operators or something like that. But here we don't need to be specific. Okay, so we have these structures, and now we assume that every point X in M has an open neighborhood, so exists an open neighborhood U. So open neighborhood simply means an open set, but X should be an element of the set. And the homo now we need a homeomorphism. Which is denoted phi sub u, which maps pi to the minus 1 of u to u cross y, the so-called local trivialization. Such that the following diagram commutes. I mean, let me just draw this and then I hope it will be clear. Such that the following diagram commutes. Okay, so we start here with pi to the minus 1 of U. I mean, this is just an open subset of, maybe I write this here too. This is an open subset of B, where simply since pi is continuous, the preimage of any open set is open. So we have here an open subset of the bundle. Okay, then we have the mapping phi sub U, which maps this to U cross Y. Now we have additional mappings, so we have the mapping pi, which maps again to U. Okay, and also here we have a projection operator where we simply forget about the second factor, maybe I call this here the trivial, the mapping, and I don't even give this a name. This is the mapping which, so here, which to a pair, let's just call it x comma little y, is mapped to x. So we simply drop the second factor. This is kind of a whatever people call trivial projection or natural projection operator. And now this diagram should commute in the sense that if I go like this, this is the same as going like this. Okay. One also says that locally the bundle looks like a topological product. Well, in this Y here with a vector space. So just U cross a vector space. Good, so now we need one more condition, namely all these local trivializations should be compatible. What does this mean? Suppose we consider two local trivializations. Let phi u and phi v be local trivializations. And x, the point in the intersection of u and v. Okay, then we can consider phi v to the minus 1. So I mean, it's a homeomorphism, so we can also take the inverse. And then we restrict this to x cross y. Then we can compose this with phi u. And let's call this mapping g u v v of x. Well, and this is a mapping from x cross y to itself. Well, the base point is fixed, so therefore this is essentially a mapping from the vector space y to itself. And now we assume that this mapping is even a linear mapping, and it's an element of our group. So this means this should be an element of G. So we assume that G u v of x is in our group G and that it depends continuously on x. So that is, let me write this down again. So this means the GUV is a mapping from U intersected with V to G, and this mapping should be continuous. Okay, so this is the definition of a topological vector bundle. So the resulting structure. So this is this topological space B, M. Well, and then there's the collection of all the local trivializations. So this is referred to as a topological vector bundle with fiber y. And structure group G. Okay, so structure group, fiber, topological vector bundle. Okay, so this is the general definition of a bundle, and the way to think of this is that, well, we have the base space, and then at each point of the base there's a vector space attached, but in a way which is maybe topologically non-trivial. Of course, the simplest example is that you take the product B is simply M cross y with the obvious trivialization maps. This is one example, but this is not the typical example, I would say, at least not the interesting example. I mean, the point is that this product structure is there usually only locally, but globally the topology can be whatever, it can be twisted, it can have a different non-trivial topology. Okay, so this is the most general definition, just the topological vector bundle. Of course, often or in most applications, one assumes more. One wants kind of smoothness, manifold structure. And let me just explain this in words because it's rather straightforward. Namely, if we now consider a topological vector bundle in the setting of, say, differential geometry, then M is a smooth manifold of dimension n. B is then also a smooth manifold, and the dimension is, of course, increased by the dimension of the vector space. So then B and M are manifolds. This means one has all these charts, and then one also needs to assume that all these charts are compatible. So in other words, just, well, adding the structure of a manifold to M and B gives you the vector bundle with manifold structure, and smoothness can then be defined by the condition, well, that all the transition maps, both of charts and of the local trivialization, so this mapping considered here, that they are all smooth mappings. So this means here not just continuous, but smooth. And of course, for smoothness in U cap V, we take the smooth structure of the base manifold. Okay, I think this is all we need in this online course. And I should say that these vector bundles are needed, at least strictly speaking, only towards the end of this lecture course when we talk about topological spinner bundles. I think even before, it's helpful to think of or to be familiar a little bit to know what a topological vector bundle is, because the causal fermion system has, at least under certain regularity assumption, the structure of a topological vector bundle. But as I said, this will be considered systematically only towards the end of this lecture course. Okay, good. I hope you found this instructive. This also ends the videos on the mathematical preliminary. So this means now you should be ready to enter the main online course, and I wish you fun and success in going through the other videos and in learning all the material. Okay, so I hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.